In one of their most ambitious fixes to date, Freddy and Juan will transform Levi's mind with a high-velocity electronic blasting system to break up gold-bearing ore from his vein. Instead of driving material down a hazardous road, a 180-foot-long pipe means they can send it straight from the jaw crusher on level 3 to the mill on level 2. Juan will build a bespoke sluice to catch the first of the freed gold. Finally, to increase production, they will add a concentrating spiral to process any remaining material and separate leftover gold that escapes the sluice.
How's it going, guys?
Going, how are you doing?
Doing all right.
Excellent. We kind of came up with some ideas. We want to run them past you guys and see what you think.
Gotcha.
We want to run a 4-inch pipe all the way from the top down here. And we'll have it suspended. That's going to streamline that whole process.
We're looking at a spiral, concentrating spiral.
Oh.
So put it in place, put a sluice box in place of the table. And then out of the end, it goes into a catch pin, pump that material up to the top of the spiral, cut the heavies out of the spiral.
We know you ran a sluice box before. You were getting a little bit of, loss.
Carryover.
Yeah. And that's fine. But if we can get your production up by 200-400%,
exactly,
that 10-15% loss, really, it's not a big deal when you're running that much more material. Mm-hmm. And then on top of that, you know, you're going to get to a point where you're going to have a hard time with that vein, with that little roto hammer. So we got a guy back home that actually does a lot of blasting with us with that little blaster.
Oh,
and we're going to get him up here, and he's going to teach you guys how to use it properly.
That's awesome.
Well, what we came up with as far as costs go, we're thinking it's going to be around 7,000 in materials.
For the labor. We're thinking about 4 ounces at the end of the season. You don't need to pay it now, but at the end of the season.
That is not going to be an issue. If the production goes up and we can get the gold, we can make it work.
Okay.
Yeah, I think we can.
We have to.
Yeah.
In Washington State, Juan follows up his lead for some equipment that could be a game changer for Levi's mine.
We've never used a spiral concentrator before. We're really hoping it's going to give them that edge that they need to be able to run more material.
Invented by Ira B. Humphreys in 1943, the concentrating spiral was a common sight on wash plants in the 40s and 50s. It uses gravity and water to separate heavy gold from lighter waste material. Pay dirt, pumped to the top of the spiral, descends down the chute. As pay swirls to the ground, the centrifugal force created by the spiral pushes the lighter waste material up to the outer edges, while heavier gold clings to the inside, before dropping into a series of ports to carry the gold away for processing.
You know, unless they can actually get their throughput up, they're going to have a hard time making it out there.
20 miles from the claim, Juan inspects the 80-year-old spirals to make sure they are still usable.
That's them, huh? These are pretty cool. They're cast iron. They're going to be heavy, but I'm just going to use the one. So I'll use the better of the bunch. We can refinish that. So I'm probably going to clean it and repaint them, recoat them.
Yeah.
Because you want it as smooth as possible. But really, they're in good shape. We'll take them. Okay. Thank you, Andy.
My pleasure.
Awesome. They're heavy.
A little more. Perfect. That's good.
So there's actually 3 on this stand, but really we only need the one. So we'll get this one cut off, finish the stand for it, and we'll just use the one. We want to make sure that this thing is strapped down right to the trailer so we don't lose it. It's a beautiful piece though, it really is. I'm sure collected a lot of gold over the years. Either way, it's, you know, it's a piece of history that's going to get put back into play. We don't know how it's going to work until we get it in place and actually run it. I'm hoping that we'll be able to run more material, ultimately getting more gold for them.
We've extended the footprint of this spiral by using this wood. That'll make it more stable every direction. Got to get the dirt out of it first.
At Fix headquarters, Freddy and Alex continue the spiral refurb.
There's about 9,400 of these made, and most of them are still in use today.
Hardly any of them are used today.
According to the internet, it says most of these are still in use.
Don't believe everything you see on the internet.
Freddy has to clear 80 years of debris from the spiral's pipes before it's usable.
This pipe's packed up with stuff. I've been beating on it with a hammer to no avail. We'll give it a colonoscopy and a throat check here and try to get all that out of it.
You're maybe an inch or two into the blockage, but if you feel up in there, that's all rubber.
Feels like the pipe collapsed on itself or something.
No bueno.
The 80-year-old rubber lining has collapsed into the pipe.
We're just out of time, so just got to do whatever we can to get this going. Pull a little more. That's better. Right now, there's a rubber liner in this pipe that's collapsed onto itself, and we can't get it removed, so I'm going to try to burn it out of there.
At 5,700 degrees Fahrenheit, Freddy's oxyacetylene blowtorch burns through the antique rubber.
We tap it on it now, do anything with the hammer?
It ain't gonna hurt anything. Hit it some more.
A bunch of it right here. That's clean.
There we go. Son of a gun. It's always something, huh?
Always something. Never easy.
It worked better than anticipated, so I'm happy with that. All right, here we go. Wish us luck. Corey, it's so beautiful.
Is it beating down there?
Oh yeah, we got a great beat. I like it. It's just dropping.
Good beat.
Hey, Juano.
Good job, buddy.
Good job, dude.
We've got the material coming down the chute, going into our pipe with the two vibrators. It's running perfectly.
This is my third pan off the end of the sluice. I haven't seen one speck of gold in it yet, which is a darn good sign. That means that sluice is working great.
The spiral's actually working really well. Freddy's actually been panning it as we've been running. He hasn't seen one color in this yet. The sluice is catching the majority of the gold. Everything's working perfectly now.
Well, there's a lot more gold than last time. Well, we got enough to weigh this time.
That's weighable. You know, before we barely had a little streak in that pan. Now we actually have an amount that you can see. And the big difference was, you know, before you guys ran a 150 pounds, maybe not even that.
Mm-hmm. This time we ran probably 500 pounds.
Yeah. Yep. Honestly, watching it run, you know, I think we can actually turn that up a little more.
I think so, too.
I honestly think that we can almost double that.
Mm-hmm.
For sure.
Moment of truth.
Let's do this.
It's not a fortune, but it's gold.
Exactly.
Well, there's weighable amount, 0.02. There's 0.05. There's 0.07. There's $160 worth of gold, guys. Probably 50 times the amount of gold you had in the first run.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's amazing.
Freddy and Juan have increased the volume going through the plant by 233%. Over a six-day week, the gold weigh equates to 1.68 ounces, worth $3,864.
Watching you guys feed it at the end there, I'm like, you know, I really think we can put more through that hammer mill. 0.07, you might be able to get that in an hour.
Exactly.
Right?
Doubling volume run through the plant will see Levi and Corey exceeding their 3-ounce-a-week target.
Seeing this, it just gives me goosebumps too, because I know how him and I are. We're just going to be sitting there and feeding that chute.
The more material they can run through the plant, the more gold they can recover. I'm really hopeful for these guys. I think this is just a start for them.